Hello friends, welcome. Today I want to make another video about suffering and, you know, are we endeavouring to overcome suffering or do we see ourselves as a victim? Because if you see yourself as a victim, then you are going to lull in suffering for as long as you do that. You know, I've been a victim of spiritual attacks and possessions and torture and all kinds of really bad stuff. But I never classed or saw myself as a victim. I am a victim, yes, I still am. But if you see yourself as a victim and submit to being that, then you're giving up on yourself and you're giving up on overcoming it and getting better. So don't see yourself as a victim, you know, because there is good and bad in this world and we do suffer a lot, and some of us more than others, but there's plenty of people probably out there suffering much worse than what we are, and it's all about learning to cope, isn't it? So, and to find those things that make us happy and balanced and different things. So if you're a victim, what do you usually do? You try everything you can to escape it, everything to run away from it, but it's still there and it doesn't go away. And all the time you keep running away from suffering rather than accepting it, that, you know, you're going to be a victim and you're going to keep trying to escape, aren't you? So some things in life we can't escape from. You know, there are terrible things in the world that somebody else is inflicting onto us maybe, or some situation that we can't escape, and we're looking for somebody else to help set us free. But even in those circumstances, when you're being tortured by somebody, anything like that, you know, you can still see yourself as a victim and you won't deal with it as well as what you could if you accepted that it's part of your life at the moment and you don't know how long it's going to last. It might be indefinitely. And the probability is it will be indefinitely if you don't overcome it. So that coming to acceptance that, you know, there's a problem in your life, and admitting it to yourself that you can't run away from it. And it's like the Buddhists, you know, I'm suffering in this lifetime because of past life karma. So they accept it. It's just a way for them to accept the suffering, isn't it? And deal with it. And, you know, say it's part of life, inescapable because of what I did in the past. So I've got to do my best just to live this life as it is. So that's not a bad philosophy. However, not quite true. There is no past life karmic debt. But it's a great way of learning to accept suffering and saying, well, I've got to deal with it. And when you start dealing with suffering, then you're on a pathway of getting better. And it is a mountain to climb. No matter how you suffer, it's a mountain for you to climb. But the truth is that each and every single one of us on this world has got to learn to save ourselves from suffering or any other affliction to deal with it better. Now, it's often we can't cope. And, you know, it's a slow process of walking up that mountain. Because when you become accepting of your suffering and saying, you know, I can either lay down here and be a victim forever or get up and persevere with a lot of determination and faith and belief in myself that I can get past this thing, that I can overcome this darkness in my life and leave it behind, is that you will start walking up that mountain. And if you let yourself be a victim again when you're on that pathway, you go back to the beginning. Or if you give up, you go back to the beginning, just as bad as you were before. Or lay by the wayside and don't try to get any better. Then you're never going to fully overcome that suffering and come to terms with it. So you've got to keep walking that mountain. And, you know, a man said the mother of success is failure, because you are suffering and you will get knocked down and you have bad days and you feel defeated at times, but the mother of success is keep picking yourself up again and confronting it, suffering, and saying, I'm not going to let you beat me, I'm going to beat you. And, you know, it's of the mind suffering greatly. We have physical suffering too, but even physical suffering is, you know, in the mind, isn't it? because if we didn't have a brain or a mind, it don't matter what pain or whatever we'd be in, we would have no conscious awareness of it. So all suffering is reflected in the mind. So it is that we have to strengthen. And we can have logical sides of the mind that are suffering, incensed, traumatized, emotions the same, insecurities, different things that can cause us to be insecure and suffering and different things. So we have to strengthen our mind, and it's a transition getting better of walking up a mountain with perseverance and determination, because perseverance pays off. And this is the pathway I've been on. I spent from 95 being so badly attacked by spirit and possessed and all different things until 2008, and then I found I could start to get better, and I soon realized each and every single human soul on this world and most other species, if they want to get better, have got to save themselves, because there's no miracle cure. There's no savior coming to rescue us. We have to save ourselves. So we have to walk that pathway of overcoming the burdens of suffering, don't we? And it is that mountain. It may be many mountains. And I had a reading given to me from a medium, and Father God gave them that reading to give me. And it was about right at the beginning of this, back in 95. It said, the medium come up on the rostrum. She said, I was going to give this reading tonight, but I've been given a different one. And it's for the man in the purple shirt. And that's my favourite colour. I was wearing a purple T-shirt. She came to me. She said, this reading was just given to me upstairs by spirit. I knew it was Father God after the reading. And it said, you've got many rivers to ford, many mountains to climb, and it's your strength and your courage that will see you through this thing to get to the other side. And that's the way it's been a roller coaster of up and down, but I've tolerated them and suffered them and got to the point where I could start getting better and overcome and almost fully back to normal now. And they're still doing it to me, still trying to knock me back down, because they're conspiring against Father God's awakening of this earthly plane and his instruments here. That's me. So it's that determination I've had and perseverance never to give up on getting back to normal again, what I used to once be, a well-balanced individual. And step by step, I'm getting there. And you can do that too. But if you let yourself be a victim and you just want to suffer, then you will. But if you want to get better, you've got to walk that mountain. And you have to slowly learn to cope and overcome the burdens and mentalities that of your mind, and you have to address those things in your mind, in your subconscious, that are suffering in your emotions, to find more security and bring out the lighter nature of yourself. Because when we're suffering, we feel very negative all the time, don't we? Our mind makes us feel negative. We got depression, and I had depression. I've had several mental illnesses, many mentalities that I've overcome them all. I had a great emotional insecurity. I was emotionally detached for many years. So many, many things I've overcome that everybody can virtually do. Everybody, if they've got a mind to, if they've got the determination to, they can persevere to the top of that mountain. And it's one step at a time. You can't take big leaps because it's a slow transition of mind, attitude, thinking, nature, different things that help you to get to that top of the mountain. But if you believe you can do it, then you probably will get there. It might take many years, but if you believe in yourself, then you've got a chance. If you feel defeated, if you submit, if you surrender, you're never going to get there to the top of your mountain of suffering. And you could suffer all this lifetime, and you go into the spirit realm and you'll be no better off there, because you've got to learn this lesson of coping with suffering, because it's what is the natures that exist of light and dark, and they still exist within the spirit realm too. So if you just give up on yourself and want to pass over into the spirit realm and say, I've had enough of this life, I'm going to go get rid of myself and go into the next life, you'll be just as bad off there, because it's no different. We still have the same lessons. So perseverance in this life and staying here to do it is the best thing. So one step at a time to the top of the mountain, gradually you will get there if you believe in yourself, if you have enough determination. And it's about casting out darkness, casting out mentalities, casting out suffering, casting out your negative side of yourself, reprogramming your subconscious mind to be the way you want it to be because it's feeling this way or that way or despondent or depressed. You've got to re-educate your subconscious mind because you're the master of your own domain. Your conscious mind, quite often it's your subconscious mind making you feel these negative, sad, unhappy, depressed things, and you have got to be the positive conscious mind within yourself to go out and reprogram it. Say, I don't like you being like this. You've got to be better than this. I don't want to feel like this. I don't want to feel like that. So it's about asserting yourself on your subconscious mind to make it gradually change for the better and bring that lighter nature back into your mind, into your body, into your spirit. Because when you're feeling miserable, your whole spirit is dampened and feeling low in energy, grey or dark muddy colours, so you can brighten yourself up again and begin to flower and feel happy. And you know, I thought I'd never feel peaceful because I was mentally deranged with all these things that were happening to me. I thought I could never feel peaceful again in my mind, never feel happy. I couldn't even smile. I was that depressed. I could never smile. But I can these days. I can be happy. So I am happy. I've got emotionally balanced. I've got logically on my logical side. I've overcome so many things like anger problems, different problems I was going through, because you can do it if you want. It is determination and belief that you can that will get you there to the top of that mountain. And ultimately, when you get to the top, what you really find is the ability to cope and equilibrium within your mind, spirit, body, and, you know, soul. And, you know, you find yourself on a level playing field where you can still be going through the same suffering, but you can deal with it, and you've come to terms with it. That's the thing. You've come to terms with your suffering, because all the time you're suffering loves company, all the time you keep saying, I can't cope with this, I can't cope with that, I can't cope with the other, it's because you're not coping. But when you get to that top of that mountain, you become the mountain of strength because you've walked to the top of it. You have become the mountain itself. So you come to terms with it and accept it and come to terms with it, and you find yourself being able to live, even with that same suffering happening, very happily balanced in a healthy state of mind, spirit and body and soul. So you've cast it all out and left it behind, even if it's still happening. You know, it might be somebody else being nasty to you. It might be a situation of life. It might be that you're on your own. It might be many things. It might be insecurity, but you can put yourself back to rights again if you have the determination, if you have the perseverance, if you believe in yourself, you can do that. So do that, you know, have that positive attitude that you can beat this thing that you're going through, and you truly will eventually. And don't ever give up, because you're going to fall down lots of times. Pick yourself up again. Don't let this thing defeat you. No, you are the master of your own domain, and you can overcome anything, and you will eventually, if you believe in yourself. Love and light to you. Bless you. Neil.